So, the captain's not here, only Skeletor. And it's Saturday morning cereals. No, He-Man was not on Saturday mornings. He was on weekday mornings and afternoons. So, that being said, Skeletor is going to bring you cartoons this week. Maybe. I don't know. I can't do this. It's too hot.
So, good morning, platoon. It's Saturday. It's 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, and you know what that means. It's time for Saturday morning cartoons. As always, I'm your host, the Captain, bringing you the best in cartoons from the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, and 2000s. So, you know, the Captain likes mixing it up, being fun, likes playing around. Got myself a new Skeletor mask this week, and it is hot. It is miserably hot in that mask. I tried to walk upstairs to mess with the wife, and it is impossible to breathe in that thing. I'm not kidding you, man. It's impossible. So, you know, there's no air holes in it, man. The eye holes are little tiny eye holes right above the eyes, like right here. Yeah, like that much space. And it sucks. It's hard to breathe and hard to wear. But it looks really cool. It looks legitimately like a giant original Skeletor head. So, alright. So, now it's time to get serious. Saturday Morning Serials is brought to you by RU Game, the best comic book collectible video game. Magic, RPG, Toy Store located at 124 North Sunset Drive, Pickle, Ohio, 45356. And you can find us on YouTube. YouTube, as you watch me right now on YouTube. You catch us on Facebook at RU Game, the word R, the letter U, Game. You can also find Pickle Comic Con, because that's coming soon. So, I keep mixing these cartoons up and playing with them and adding stuff. You know, last week, there at the end, I threw some Roswell conspiracies on there. Not a show I got into right away. It's a show I found later, discovered, and enjoyed. It's a little bit of Men in Black, a little bit of Batman Beyond, a little bit of Batman style. I mean, it's got a very, very traditional art style. So, but I liked it. But we're going back because, man, I just love putting these two cartoons together. And we're going to bring you Journey to the Center of the Earth. This is episode 10. Enjoy.
Long ago, a lone explorer named Arne Saknussemm made a fantastic descent to the fabled lost kingdom of Atlantis at the Earth's core. After many centuries, his trail was discovered, first by me, Professor Oliver Lindenbrook, my niece Cindy, student Alec McEwen, our guide Lars, and his duck Gertrude. But we were not alone. The evil Count Saknussemm, last descendant of the once noble Saknussemm family, had followed us to claim the center of the Earth for his power-mad schemes. He ordered his brute-like servant Torg to destroy our party. But the plan backfired, sealing the entrance forever. And so for us began a desperate race to the Earth's core to learn the secret of the way back. This is the story of our new journey to the center of the Earth.
Captain, strong, Professor. We'll never make it.
Yeah, and it's getting stronger.
What happened?
Alec. Where's Alec?
He was here just a moment ago.
What was that?
Hello? Is someone there?
I will handle it. You two stay behind me. Gertrude!
She's trying to tell us something.
Alec, what happened?
I was caught in an avalanche. Almost buried me alive.
We'll have to turn back and find another way.
We can't.
Why?
I'll show you.
This must be the way. Let's go. Lars, give me your axe.
What are you going to do, Uncle Oliver?
Simple use of aerodynamics. Run, quickly!
Professor, you stopped the wind. But how?
Simple. That avalanche I caused blocked the cave and stopped the wind.
It is smart.
There's light coming from there.
What a weird light.
Strange. Like the Aurora Borealis.
The Aurora what?
The Aurora Borealis. Northern lights at the North Pole.
Yeah, it's beautiful. But where it come from and what causing it?
Let's find out.
The source of the light seems to come from behind that valley, way over there.
Ooh, isn't it beautiful? Could it be Atlantis?
Or one of Count Saknussemm's tricks?
There's only one way to find out. Let's go see.
Look at that.
Beautiful.
Amazing.
Yeah. Amazing!
What is this diamond doing out here?
A large diamond? Giving off light like an aurora borealis? Where have I heard of it before?
If this king belonged to somebody, Deus might not like us here.
Nonsense. We're not doing any harm.
What are we going to do? We don't have any weapons.
Yes, we have.
You're getting closer.
You all run, quick. It is your only chance.
Oh, they followed our tracks.
What do we do, Professor?
I'm afraid, Alec, that the next move is theirs.
What are they doing, Uncle Oliver?
Professor?
Totem poles? Well, what is this?
It looks like a note.
Correct, Alec. In fact, it's a message from Arnie Saknussemm.
What does it say?
It says, look for the flaw in the diamond.
The Aurora Borealis diamond.
Exactly. But what does he mean, the flaw?
They found the note we were looking for. Count Saknussemm.
Yes, Tog, but it will do them no good. I have no choice but to stop them right now.
But what about these totem poles, Uncle Oliver?
I remember reading of a legend. It was called The Living Totems of Saskatchewampum. There was a large diamond, and these totems look strangely familiar.
Be bothered by that meddling fool and his helpers. I have a plan for getting that diamond. Let's go.
Let's try to find Lars.
Oh!
Why do you bring violence to to our village again?
Violets. Violets.
We've never been here before.
It was one of your kind that brought the darkness upon us.
Darkness. Darkness.
Once we were happy. Not so long ago, a strange being like yourself came to our valley. He said he had heard of our great diamond and how it could show the way towards the center of the earth. We look upon it as our god and protector. He convinced us to take the diamond outside the safety of the temple, where, set upon large stone, it would cast the shadow of its flaw on the entrance to the path toward the center of the earth. The snowman, whose cavern was always in twilight, saw that our diamond would give their cavern light and swoop down on us like madmen, stealing our precious diamond from us. Your Onisaknusen made us so angry that we drove him from our valley under threat of death. What is to be done with you?
If only Alec and Lars were here.
We can only hope they're better off than we are.
Time of Nick.
Lars, you're safe. What happened to the snowman?
You did. Where is the professor and Cindy?
Well,
I think we better go first. You tell me on the way.
We have decided.
Yes, yes.
You will face the ice pit of no return.
Stop!
Lars!
Lars, look out!
So you did not bring violence with Professor.
Lies, lies.
Lars meant no harm. He was only trying to save us.
No more tricks. Your punishment will be an example to all who invade our valley. With evil intent, you will all be dropped into the ice pit of no return.
Stop. We'll get your diamond back. Keep Lars and myself as prisoners, and let Alec and Cindy bring back the diamond. After all, you're not able to get the diamond yourself. We'll still be your hostages.
True. And you will be in danger only if your young friends do not bring me diamond back, or if they do not return at all. You have a chance to save them.
We will.
Good. We want nothing more than to get back our diamond.
May I have a word with them before they go?
Certainly.
Alec, if you can't get the diamond, don't come back.
But...
No!
You must go now! I hope they succeed. For your sake.
Just a little farther, Cindy. We're almost there.
How can you tell?
I just keep going towards the strongest source of light, because that's where the diamond will be. Shh. I think I hear something, and the light is getting bright, too. There they are.
There sure are a lot of them. What can we do?
There's too many of them. So rather than fight them, we're going to join them.
But how?
I'll show you.
Alec, I'm cold.
Sorry, but we've got to disguise ourselves to look like snowmen.
You're right. Let's go. What are we going to do?
Make a break for it. I'm going to grab the diamond and run.
But Alec...
Now, let's go!
Maybe we can hide somewhere.
Not a chance. The light from the diamond will give us away.
Oh, dear, here they come.
I'm too slow with this rock, and they're too fast.
If there was only some way of getting help.
Perhaps that can be arranged.
The Count and Torg, they can help us.
The only one they help are themselves.
But look, they're throwing us a rope.
Do but go back to the totems. We've got to get the professor and Lars out of there.
Well, Lars, I'm afraid Alec and Cindy didn't succeed.
Yeah, I just hope they're safe.
It appears your two companions have deserted you.
Never!
They would have brought your diamond back if they could.
If there was only some way to get out of this.
Lars, look!
That's it, Gertrude. Now the professor.
Lars, look! Get ready, Lars. They're going to rush us.
Again, violence!
Violence.
You see why your kind are not to be trusted. You create trouble. We've had enough of your trouble.
We have no wish to harm you. We were just trying to gain our freedom.
No! You must be example. All who would come help to disturb us. Take them to the ice pit.
Say, that's weird.
What?
It's getting lighter.
It is. Why would...
That's why. Look over there. Coming toward us.
Keep going.
Need light to see where to go.
Oh, no! Douse the light, you fool! They'll think we have the diamond.
But I can't see where I am going.
Now you've done it, you fool! Here they come!
Good sight for our frozen eyes.
Wait a minute. I see them, but I don't see any diamond.
Wait. See what they have to say first.
All right. Then you can all go into the ice pit together. You see? No diamond.
Why did you come back? I told you to.
Wait.
Now let's see if the totems will use the diamond to show us the way to the center of the earth.
Oh, yeah, the floor.
Now that we've brought back your diamond, perhaps you'll show us the way to Atlantis.
You have fulfilled your part of the bargain. Now we will help you. Now, when the diamond is set into the pedestal properly, you brought violence upon us again?
We didn't. They saw the light from the diamond. We've got to do something. Lars, get the diamond.
Yeah, Lars, do it.
Let's hope it can concentrate enough light to melt snow.
The snowmen! Gone! All gone!
At least for a while. That avalanche cut them off from this valley.
There! Now, Professor, for getting us our diamond. And for defeating our enemies, the snowmen. You have shown us that not all of your kind are violent as we thought.
From the floor has revealed the trail. We'll be on our way now.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Yeah, goodbye.
Goodbye. Good luck.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Well, this seems to be it. We're on our way.
I hope so.
So do I.
Center of the earth, here we come.
Now watch these exciting scenes from future episodes of the all-new Journey to the Center of the Earth.
Thank you. believe this urgent call to action. Mayhem is broken out of the dastardly domain of Ming the Merciless. Soldiers are urgently needed. Join me, Flash Gordon, and Team Flash as we mow down evil with Rebel Air Bikes. Rock the universe in the Trifibian and space surf on our air sleds. It'll be a blast. So join Team Flash today. Otherwise, we'll return you to your regular...
The Transformers, more than meets the eye.
Power 全開、サイバトロン総司令官、コンボイ発進。君の知らない超ロボットバトル、今始まる。作戦を指揮するのは君だ。
頑張れコンボイ、メガトロンを倒せ。負けるものだ。
戦え、超ロボット生命体、トランスフォーマー。
All right, I hope you guys still like Journey to the Center of the Earth. Not a whole lot of episodes left after this one, but we'll keep it running until we are done. I gotta ask you guys, do you like it when I do that? Do you just like when I just take a series and then run with it? Or do you want me to keep mixing it up week to week? Or do it like I've been doing? Do episodes keep going while episodes change? Whatever, just let me know. So we're gonna keep it in the same ballpark. The same Filmation ballpark, and we're going to bring you Fantastic Voyage. This is Fantastic Voyage, episode 11, and this is Spy Satellite. Enjoy.
Headquarters. CMDF. Combined Miniature Defense Force. Project
Fantastic Voyage.
Process Miniaturization. Authority Top Secret Highest Clearance. Team Jonathan Kidd Commander. Guru Master of Mysterious Powers. Erica Lane Doctor Biologist. Busby Birdwell, scientist, inventor, builder of the Voyager. Mission, in their miniaturized form, to combat the unseen, unsuspected enemies of freedom. Time limit,
12 hours.
Series of successful sabotage attempts at our most important installations.
What beats me is how they always know exactly where to go.
It's as if they had pictures.
We believe they do, Miss Lane. Pictures taken from this satellite by a camera that takes photos through solid walls.
Boy, that sure beats my old brownie. Who thought that up?
We don't know yet.
What's our job, sir?
It's very simple.
Yes, you're to get inside the satellite and knock it out without being discovered.
Simple, huh?
You mean, we've got to go all the way up there?
Oh, come on, Busby. Think of the view.
That's exactly what I am thinking of.
Ready, Mr. Kidd?
Let her rip, Professor.
Start process.
space launch.
Wow, this is some ride.
Look out there.
You are now leaving Earth's atmosphere.
Couldn't we stop and talk this over or something?
You're in orbit, Mr. Kid. Keep your eyes open.
We will, Professor.
Yeah, tell them we'll send them a snapshot from Mars.
Aren't you ever serious, Busby? We've got... Oh, oh, darn, I forgot. Get me down.
I thought you liked heights.
Oh, very funny. Just...
We are approaching our objective.
We've spotted it, Professor. Signing off. See you later.
Get me down, Guru.
As you wish, Miss Lane.
Ouch!
Take it easy, Busby. Let's look it over first.
Okie doke.
See any place to get in, Busby?
There's some sort of valve over there, but I can't tell what it is.
I'll take a look. Drift in close.
Be careful.
Just don't let go of the cable. It's a long way down.
Yeah, like never. Well, bombs away.
What's it look like?
It'll open all right if I can figure out how.
Wait, Mr. Kid. Do not open it. There is danger.
What? Just a second. I'm getting it.
Mr. Kid.
It's no use. He can't hear you.
Oh, no. It's an acid tank.
Busby, get out of here.
Get Kid in first. Hurry up. Come on. We can't wait much longer.
Oh, it's getting inside.
We must depart, Mr. Birdwell.
But he's still out there.
Can't help it. Hang on.
But what about Jonathan?
We can only hope the cable is strong.
Oh! It's frozen the exhausts. I'm heading down. We'll have to burn it off as we re-enter the Earth's atmosphere.
Hold on, Jonathan.
Temperature?
400 degrees below zero, minus 250. Minus 75.
Coming close now.
30 above. 50. 75. 90. 110. 140.
They're melting. Reverse our course, Mr. Birdwell.
Right. Start bringing Kid in. If he's still there to bring in...
Will he be alive, Miss Lane?
I don't know. An ordinary man could never have survived, but he might. The table, Guru.
Is he, you know?
No, he's still alive, but barely. Oxygen, quickly. Set up the automatic transfusion. There's still a chance. A small one.
Any change?
None. Still no telling.
Only 8 hours to go. The satellite will orbit past in 2 minutes. What do we do?
Our mission was to destroy the camera. We must perform it.
No, we can't take the chance.
We have chosen to walk with chance, Miss Lane.
For once, I agree with Guru. We've got a job to do. There, right on schedule. Fasten Kid down. We're moving. Like we got a break. The valve's still open. I just hope the acid's all out.
What's going on?
The hole created a vacuum, and we're going to the cleaners. Cross your fingers.
Part of us did, anyway.
Where are we, Mr. Birdwell?
I
think we're inside the camera. Those must be the lenses, and that electronic tape records the pictures.
What about the screen?
Well, it's probably... Hey, it looks like we arrived just in time for the next show. Let's park.
Is it taking pictures now?
Yeah. Pictures of its next targets for sabotage. Now we'll see what they plan to destroy next.
What? That's...
Our headquarters! The dirty dogs!
There's Professor Carter.
Come on. This will be a pleasure.
What about Jonathan?
This won't take long. And he's sure not going anywhere. I'll get the tape. You and Erica take care of the lenses and make sure you don't get in front of them. Now for a little retouching job. Now let's see. Well, now that's what I call a good picture.
Wait until you see this one. Ready, Guru? Here goes. Now try it.
Beautiful!
My Professor Carter, how you've changed.
Let us return. Our mission is finished.
Right. Let's go. So much for the spy satellite.
I'd like to see their faces when... It's impossible. He can't... Where?
He is outside.
Look out. Acid. Got to get back. Don't close door.
Jonathan, come back.
Oh, no. He's heading for the lens. No, kid. Stop.
What? Light? Bright?
We've got to get him out of there.
I wanted to see their faces. I didn't want them to see ours.
We must hurry, Mr. Birdwell.
You're telling me!
What? What is...
Silence! So, that explains what is wrong. The satellite is being sabotaged from inside.
What? How? It's not possible.
Silence! Have you no eyes? It is Kid and his blasted CMDF, but they shall not escape. Seal the satellite immediately.
Where are we?
In the wrong place, and at the wrong time. Let's go, Busby.
What do you think I'm doing, looking for a parking space? Uh-oh, dead end.
Over there, Busby. Get through there.
Too late. It's too late all around. We're trapped.
It is sealed. May I suggest?
You may suggest nothing. Direct the satellite back to Earth.
Yes.
What's that? Listen.
No signal. I wonder. Look, up there. They're changing our course. To return to Earth.
This is what I call trouble. We're helpless.
But maybe not as helpless as they think.
Jonathan, are you all right?
I think so. Busby, can you make that camera work again?
I suppose so. Why?
Because if they're bringing us back to their base, we ought to get some pretty good pictures of it.
And if we contact Professor Carter,
they can receive the pictures there.
That's it. Let's get to work. Okay, ready? Ready? Okay, shoot. Somebody be listening, please.
Professor, we're getting picture signals from the spy satellite.
What?
Look.
What is this? A picture? But I ordered no.
Look, it is us. But that's not possible.
Silence! It is us. Kid has turned our camera on us. And they're transmitting the pictures to their headquarters.
It is you, Luke.
Professor Vladimir Estragon. So he's behind all this.
Boy, look at that face. He looks plenty mad.
He's got plenty to be mad about. When his bosses find out about this, I wouldn't like to be in his shoes.
Stop them! They must be stopped immediately! At once!
Picking it up. Keep it up, Busby.
Blow up that satellite immediately.
Destroy it.
What's that?
It's the self-destruct mechanism. There must be a bomb in there somewhere.
Look, it's starting. Do something.
6, 5, 4.
It's too late now.
So long, everyone. About you, but I think I'm still alive.
What happened?
Nothing, thank goodness.
But why not?
I don't know. Say, Busby, what's that in your hand?
This? It's just a clock I found to help time the camera exposures. Wait, you mean it came from the bomb I took? Oh, boy.
The satellite did not blow up.
Thank you for telling me. So, you think you have defeated me, Mr. Kidd? We shall see.
What's going to happen now, Jonathan?
It's their move, but you can be sure it won't be pleasant.
Woo!
Ah! Oh! Now we're going up! Why can't they make up their minds?
They have. They're casting us out into outer space and cutting us loose.
You mean just to drift?
Yes.
Victorious after all. They have neutralized my spy satellite, but I have neutralized our most dangerous enemies, Kid and his friends. Control will be pleased.
You were right, Jonathan. Will we ever stop?
I'm afraid not. We'll just drift. We'll just become another speck of dust floating around the universe. Unless... Look up there!
A meteor?
Yes. If we can maneuver into its wake.
You mean its draft might pull us back to Earth?
Yes. It sounds crazy, but it's our only chance. Now let's move this crate.
But how?
By firing the defense rockets and utilizing the opposite thrust.
Plot a course, Busby.
15 degrees east.
Fire number 3.
North.
Number 6.
Now, everything!
It worked!
Not yet, it didn't. Get into the Voyager, quickly. When and the meteor starts burning up in the Earth's atmosphere. Things are going to get mighty hot.
Things are hot enough for me already. Never mind the temperature.
It's starting.
The satellite's melting.
So am I.
Keep awake. Don't touch anything.
Professor, they will never speak.
Kid here, Professor. Are you all right?
Sure. You don't think somebody like old Sourpuss down there could stop us?
Wait! It's a mistake! I couldn't have failed.
But you have. You have.
Estegan, report to control immediately.
Well, this time we really did make it. I wonder if anyone will believe what happened.
I'm not even sure I do.
Nor am I.
Well, I am. Don't forget, we can always show them our pictures.
Adventure. That's what you get when you drive Tonka trucks like Mudrunner, Roving Wrecker, and Jeep CJ, each sold separately. Trucks so rugged, so powerful, you know they're Tonkas.
Someday you'll be driving one of these.
Till then, keep driving those Tonkas.
Why don't you drive a Tonka?
Mudrunner, Jeep CJ, and Roving Wrecker come with everything shown here, each sold separately from Tonka.
Come with me to a place.
You'll be glad that you did.
Get free.
With so much more, oh, what a store. Where Toys R Us kids. It's a magical land. So where else would you go? When everything's at Toys R Us and prices are low.
If it's new and hot,
it's a toy they've got.
And the prices are hard to beat.
Oh, neat.
You can search the whole world. The Toys R Us kids know. It's the one and only place to go.
More games.
More toys.
Oh, fun.
It's the world's biggest toy store.
Hey, so I gotta ask you guys, remember Defenders, which Defenders teams do you like? Do you like the later teams or the early team? I'm a big fan of that early team, man. All powerhouses. I mean, it's literally the Hulk, Namor, Doctor Strange, and Silver Surfer. That's some big guns. And I mean, then they added later, you know, they added Valkyrie, Nighthawk, and Hellcat. But still, that four-member team is horrendous. Man, seriously. Just saying. So, I hope you guys are still digging on Fantastic Voyage. Yet again, not a whole lot of episodes left. So, you know, I think we'll keep this one going until we are done. And we're going to keep it trucking along, and you guys have been asking for it. We're going to keep this one. And it is Return to the Planet of the Apes. Like I said, I'm a sucker for this cartoon. Don't care. Reminds me more of the book than anything else. You know, they got airplanes and stuff, which they did not have in the movies. Just saying. I liked it. So, this is a Return of the Planet of the Apes. Return to the Planet of the Apes. This is episode 8, and this is Attack from the Clouds. Enjoy.
Gigantic! Have you identified the flying object yet?
No, sir. It's like nothing we've ever seen before.
Got to identify it. It's causing panic everywhere.
Well, we're trying to get a clear fix on it, sir, but it's very difficult.
I don't care how difficult it is. Just get it done.
Sir, its flight path has become highly erratic. I think it's getting ready to attack.
What? Code red! Code red! Signal alert! Prepare to be attacked!
Alerting all units. Code red! Code red! Deploy defensive units around all military installations.
Bring up the cannon and hurry! There it is! There it is! Hurry! Get it in your sights! It's behind us! Turn the cannons around! Turn them around!
Have you identified the thing yet?
No, sir. But we don't believe it's a stolen aircraft.
Why not?
It's not making any engine noise, General Urko.
I thought our security was foolproof.
It is, sir.
Then how did it penetrate our defenses? Where's our intelligence? Why haven't our field units notified us about this thing?
They've never seen it before either, sir. They know nothing more than we do.
A plot? Could all this be a plot to undermine my leadership of the guerrilla army?
If it isn't Blue Eyes and Jeff up there, then what is it?
I'm not sure, Zira, but from its size, I can only presume it's some kind of monster.
Monster? What kind?
One we've never encountered before.
Well, Dr. Zaius, has it been determined what kind of danger Ape City is exposed to from the flying creature?
None, Your Excellencies. I am pleased to report the creature has been frightened away.
Oh? And where has this creature gone?
I have no idea, except that it no longer roams the sky above our fair city.
Excellent, Dr. Zaius. Now tell us, what is being done to apprehend the blue-eyed humanoid?
As this august body will recall, General Urko has been authorized by us to muster all weapons and ape power necessary to capture the beast.
True, Dr. Zaius. It was a difficult decision at best. After all, Urko has demonstrated an almost total lack of ability.
This is to be the General's final opportunity. He has pledged not to fail, no matter what the cost.
But if he does?
Then I shall look forward to dealing with him in the appropriate way.
And if the General locates the humanoid beast?
Then I shall recommend to this distinguished council that we authorize a full-scale attack.
New Valley is such a beautiful place. I'm sorry to leave it.
Hopefully our mission will only take us a short time, Judy. But retrieving the airplane is extremely important.
I know. We just can't let it fall back into the hands of the apes.
And the airplane is the perfect way to keep the open pass of the Ray of New Valley under constant surveillance.
That's right. If Urko discovers the pass without our knowing, it would leave the humanoids vulnerable to a guerrilla surprise attack.
How about the laser drill? You want to take it with you?
It might come in handy, but it's too valuable to risk losing.
It's going to be an extremely dangerous mission.
We know that, Jeff.
Are you sure you want to chance it? There are bound to be guerrilla patrols everywhere.
We know. We're just going to have to be extremely careful.
And prepared for every eventuality.
It looks like the humanoids finally have the kind of protection they need against Urko and his guerrillas.
And New Valley's pasture land seemed perfect for the herd.
They're sure friendly enough.
If we can enlarge the herd, they'll be a major factor in our food supply.
What's that?
It looks like some kind of a prehistoric bird, a pterodactyl or something like it.
But if it's prehistoric, what's it doing here?
Look, it's heading straight for the herd.
Oh, no! It's grabbed one of the calves.
Where's it headed?
To those caves over there.
Incredible! That monster bird picked up the calf with no trouble at all.
I wonder if it will come back.
Well, if it does, we're in real danger. It could destroy the herd.
Once the monster bird realizes we can't defend ourselves, it's bound to attack us constantly.
Is all our military equipment ready for the attack on the humanoids?
Just a boat, sir.
And what about my airplane? Have you found it yet?
Not yet, sir. But we've got patrols out searching for it.
And what have they come up with?
Nothing as yet, General Urko.
Nothing? That's all I ever hear from you. Nothing. I need that airplane for the offensive against the humanoids. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Then find it and apprehend the ape traitors who stole it.
We have no proof any apes stole the aircraft, General.
But they did! They're out to get me, I know it! They want me out and are turning everyone against me!
Could it have been the humanoids who stole the airplane, General?
No! They're too stupid to know how to fly it. It was some traitorous apes!
Sector 8 has been thoroughly searched. The plane is not there.
Then start on Sector 9. Remember, General Urko is in no mood to let us get away with failure.
I know. I've never seen the General so scared.
Or so dangerous.
How much further do you figure, Bill?
Just a few more miles. We should be there before daybreak.
That's if we don't run into any guerrilla patrols along the way.
Let's keep our eyes and ears open, and our fingers crossed.
Bill, look!
Fan out and search the area! And don't leave a stone unturned! We've search sectors 10 and 11, sir. Nothing's there.
Then start the troops looking through 12.
I've already sent an advance party that way, sir.
Smart thinking, soldier. Time's growing short.
Let's get going. We were lucky not to have been spotted before. We can't take another chance.
Bill and Judy should have reached the plane by now.
That's if they didn't run into any trouble along the way.
Oh, no! It's returned!
Take cover!
We've got to hurry, Judy. Push harder.
I can't, Phil. I'm using all the strength I have.
It's stampeding the animals.
And they're headed right at us.
Make for the cut in those rocks.
Judy.
It's just no use, Bill. It won't kick over. Let's get out of here while we can still save ourselves.
And let the plane fall back into Urko's hands? We can't do that, Judy.
The apes are coming back, Bill. We can't stay here and risk getting captured.
And if we have to leave the plane behind, let's wreck the engine so Urko can't use it.
Good idea. But before we do, let me try and start it one more time. There it goes, Bill! Hurry and climb aboard!
Someone is trying to steal the aircraft! Quick! After them! After them!
Okay, let's go.
Don't let them get away! After them!
Let her rip, Judy!
Those are humanoids in the airplane! Catch them! Catch them! Don't let the beast escape!
Yeah.
Sheriff, look. The monster bird can't get into the cave. It's too big. Well, it looks like the herd is safe for the time being.
Maybe safe from the monster bird. But unless they have food and water, the herd can't survive for very long.
But there's no other entrance to the cave.
Then we'll make another entrance by using the laser drill to cut a small opening through the hillside into the cave.
It's too dangerous. If the monster bird sees what's going on, it's bound to attack.
Maybe, but it's a risk we're going to have to take.
Well, we made it without a second to spare.
For a while there, I didn't think we would.
How's our fuel holding up?
Not very well. But if I take the direct path to New Valley, we'll save the most fuel.
But won't that take us directly over Ape City?
Yes, it will.
It's too dangerous, Judy. The apes have the firepower to shoot us down.
I think it's worth the risk, Bill. It's vital we conserve every gallon of fuel we have.
The laser drill is ready. Now, the hole has got to be cut large enough for us to get in, but small enough so the herd can't get out.
What about the monster bird? Won't it hear what's going on?
I don't think so. Not with all the noise the herd is making.
Perfect. The monster bird didn't hear a thing.
Now we've got to get food and water to the herd.
A large flying object is approaching Ape City, sir. Its position is now some 15 miles from the center of the city.
What is the object?
We don't know as yet, sir.
That figures. None of you ever seem to know anything. Well, if it's that big bird that flew over here a while ago, make sure our soldiers are smart enough to shoot it down this time.
How much more?
We're almost done.
We brought the food and water just in time. They were really hungry.
That ought to keep them for a few days. Come on, let's get going.
Jeff, the monster bird spotted us.
Let's move.
Well, that was close. The monster bird almost caught us. Jeff, the monster bird is taking off.
I wonder where it's headed.
It's my aircraft! My aircraft! I want it back! Do you all understand? I want my aircraft returned immediately! Whomever is responsible for this will pay dearly. I assure all of you, I ordered you to find the aircraft. Not let it fall into the hands of the enemy.
We were taken by surprise, sir.
Excuses! Excuses! That's all I ever hear around this place. You let them steal the airplane right from under your noses. And adding insult to injury, you allowed them to fly directly over Ape City at high noon! Why didn't you fire the cannon? Do you realize I'm the laughingstock of the city? There is something suspicious about this. A plot by traitors to get me. But I'll find out who's behind it and make them pay!
I wonder who's flying it.
Oh, come now, Zira. Surely you must know.
But I have no idea, Dr. Zaius.
Are you sure?
Oh, yes, we're quite sure, Dr. Zaius.
Well, whoever is responsible for keeping the aircraft out of General Urko's hands is performing an act of great loyalty to me. And I am very appreciative.
Well, it looks like we saved the herd.
Not quite. They can't live in the cave indefinitely. They need the open sky and land to graze.
But the monster bird is bound to return. Once the herd is out in the open, it'll be able to pick them off one by one.
That's why we need the airplane.
With it, we have a chance of scaring the thing away.
I wonder where Bill and Judy are.
Do you think they made it?
I hope so.
Take cover!
Take cover! Creature it really was.
Well, I guess we'll never have the chance to know.
Thank goodness.
Autobots Omega Supreme Defense Base. It comes with a motorized tank with flashing turret lights.
Decepticons! Counterattack, Omega Supreme!
Transformers!
in disguise.
Omega Supreme is invincible.
Transformers.
The Transformers sold separately. Batteries not included.
Spin the spinner and call the shot. Twister can tie you up in a knot. One foot here and one foot there. The spinner says what, but you decide where. You reach, you stretch, you balance and twist. You try it once, you get the gist. No two twists come out the same. Twister is a Milton Bradley game.
Twister from Milton Bradley.
Look who's smiling now. He got his college degree via mail. This is the early, probably, version of learning online that we get now. I couldn't imagine trying to learn via the mail. Holy crap. I get stuff lost in the mail now. I couldn't imagine your whole curriculum getting lost in the mail. That would suck. That would be horrible. So, but that being said, I hope you guys still like Planet of the Apes. I still like it. Not a whole lot of episodes of Planet of the Apes, so this will run out very quickly. So we're just going to run this one all out. Done. But I still like it. And you guys do too, because you keep asking for it. Because it's Planet of the freaking Apes. So, but we're going to go. We're going to take this in a completely different direction now. Because we're going, to giant mechs and robots and space and... And we're going Battletech. Yeah, that's right. Battletech. Man, I love me some Battletech. Love the mechs. The cartoon doesn't do them justice, man. The mechs and Battletech are some of them are sweet. The Mad Cat, stuff like that. Oh, those are awesome, awesome stuff. But this is a Battletech. This is episode 6. Enjoy.
Thousands of planets colonized by humankind. Once it was united under the Starling. But for the last 300 years, it has been consumed by savage wars. Until a new enemy appeared. Mysterious invaders known as the Clans. Powerful and ruthless, they struck like lightning, attacking every sector at once. But they made one big mistake. They attacked my home planet. Now in the spirit of the Star League, ancient enemies have reunited. And we're gonna take back our galaxy.
Cousin Adam, I am pleased to hear of your recent success in appropriating clan weaponry. My engineers are already incorporating the technology gleaned from your reports on their elemental armor suits. But sadly, I must turn down your request to replace your inoperative battle mechs. As you know, your official mission is intelligence gathering, not combat.
We're practically on Somerset's doorsteps, and Archon cuts us off at the knees.
I know, Adam. Somerset's my home, too. But by acquiring clan tech, we've done more for the Inner Sphere than anything we could have accomplished on Somerset.
That doesn't help our families.
Major, I just got a message from the jumpship Strongbow.
One of their dropships went AWOL. They think it might be headed our way.
Have Franklin report to Flight Deck B.
Whoa! You're trusting that guy with a Banshee?
I need a pilot out there, and unless you can earn your wings in the next 5 minutes, he's my only option. So, tell me something, Franklin.
Where did a shipping merchant like you learn to fly an aero fighter?
Did you imagine that you were the only believer in cross-training?
Not any more than I believe I'll ever get a straight answer out of you. Dropship in sight, Major.
This is Major Adam Steiner of the AFFC, hailing Dropship Hegira. Do you copy?
Repeat, this is Major Adam Steiner, hailing Dropship Hegira.
Major, look out!
Franklin!
What in blazes are you doing?
Hold your fire! Oh, guys, settle down. We're on your side.
Identify yourselves immediately. This is Major Victor Steiner Davian of the 12th Donegal Guard.
Victor Steiner Davian? As in...
That's right, Mr. Sakamoto.
You just fired on the Prince of the Federated Commonwealth. I know what I saw, Major. They were training their lasers on you.
I'd like to avoid an international incident, Franklin, so I suggest you do what you do best. Keep your mouth shut.
Major Steiner, I want this man taken into custody immediately.
I'm taking full responsibility for the incident, Galen. It's my fault for ordering radio silence. I would have done the same thing in your position, Major.
Yeah, but would you send a Drac to do the shooting?
That's enough, Galen. Let's not forget the Draconis Combine are allies now.
Your Highness, we'd better have that shoulder looked at.
You letting a Drac doctor treat the Prince?
For your information, Captain Cox, this dropship and jumpship are staffed entirely by Combine personnel.
Victor, I suggest you return to the Hegira immediately, for your own safety.
That's ridiculous. My Somerset cousin leads a fine example of cooperation with our Draconis allies.
I'm pleased you admire my work, but with all due respect, you didn't go AWOL from your jumpship just to evaluate my unit.
Okay, that's correct, Major. I'm here for something far more important. As you may know, Captain Galen Cox and I were stationed with the 12th Donegal Guard on Trelwan.
Victor, we can't hold him here much longer!
Hang in there, Galen! The clans had hit us pretty hard. Galen was doing his best to hold the Pirate Canyon Bridge. Galen, we're almost finished here! Mech made it across and chased us into the caverns. Badger 1 to Den Mother, come in. I need a new vector to the front.
Negative, Victor. You and Galen are to return to the base immediately.
But, Colonel, they need us at the front.
That's an order, Major.
You see that dropship? Get in it. Both of you.
I will not abandon my people. They're getting cut to ribbons out there. Go down in history as the man who lost Trelwan.
There's nothing I can do about that now, but I refuse to be known as the man who lost the Prince of the Federated Commonwealth. Get him out of here.
Colonel, I'm not!
I'm really sorry about this, Victor.
That was the last I ever saw of Trelwan. Before long, I found myself stranded here in the Butler system on an inoperable jump ship. You see, Major, I need your jumpship to return us to the Trelwan system so we can rejoin our battalion.
Plan from the start.
Don't mind Galen. His flak suit's wrapped a little too tight.
My orders are to see the Prince safely back to the FedCom outpost on Sudeten.
You know, I will not abandon my men simply because I happen to be the Archon's son.
Our jump drive needs a week to recharge before we can go anywhere. So in the meantime, why don't you work on your travel plans aboard the Katana?
think you'll find the accommodations there a little more comfortable.
Adam, I radioed the Strongbow and told them that the Prince is safe and sound.
Unfortunately, their jump drive will require 3 weeks' worth of repairs.
So we've been ordered to escort Victor back to the Fedcom base on Sudeten.
We're two jumps away from home and they're making us turn around?
Adam, if you don't mind my asking, what can we possibly do for Somerset with only one working mech?
Gentlemen, allow me to show you to your quarters.
Victor, get down!
We are merely taking them into storage, Steiner Devian Sama.
Nice souvenirs, Major. Where'd you get them?
More importantly, why do Drax have free access to such highly sensitive material?
Mr. Sakamoto played a pivotal role in helping us seize those suits, Captain.
I don't know what kind of operation you think you're running here, Major, but you have the heir to the throne on your ship. I suggest you start taking his safety a little more seriously.
These suits are fantastic. We could use them to infiltrate the clans on Trelwan. And Somerset.
You make a very tempting offer, cousin.
All hands, this is Lieutenant Rachel Spector. All off-duty personnel will immediately report to Dropship Quaidong.
Galen, what are you doing?
Just keeping watch. You can never be too sure.
Get some rest, Captain. That's an order. Listen, I didn't need babysitting on Trelwan, and I certainly don't need it now.
Engineering. Shut down power on Turbolift 1. You all right, Your Highness?
Forget me. I want that intruder.
Major, there's been an attempt on the Prince. I'm pursuing the intruder through Turbolift 1. Docking Collar A. Our buddy was heading for the Quaidan.
Search the jump ship. Lieutenant Spector, seal off the Quaidon and conduct an immediate headcount. I want every single crew member accounted for.
If anything's happened to the Prince, I'm holding you personally responsible.
Oh, Galen, give it a rest. I'm fine.
All personnel are accounted for, Adam, with the exception of Franklin Sakamoto. No one has seen him on the Quaidon or the Katana.
What about the Hijira? We want him alive!
Care to explain just what you were up to?
I cannot say.
Maybe you want to try.
That's enough, Captain!
Now, Franklin, you better say something in your defense, because it looks like you're either the assassin or you're protecting him.
Either way, he's guilty.
Major, I want him remanded to my custody so he can face the proper authorities.
We have no hard evidence of his guilt.
We don't. I found these in a ventilation shaft aboard the Hajira. Yours, I believe.
I simply can't accept that Franklin would be an assassin.
What are you hoping to find in his quarters?
Looks like someone left his locker open.
Uh-uh. It's been forced.
I want the Prince put on a 24-hour guard.
I still say you'd be safer on our ship.
I will not be carried away from another crisis like some helpless royal fop. I will always have enemies, Galen. Whether an outside invader or a traitor from my own family, it comes with the title. What? Do you plan to keep me under guard when we counterattack the clans on Trelwan?
You still haven't told him about our orders?
This whole thing may have an upside. Now, if the FedCom brass think Victor's in danger, then someone else is going to have to escort him back to Sudeten, leaving us free to move on to Somerset.
Careful, Adam. You just made yourself a suspect. Franklin. Why will you not confess? Your actions bring disgrace to the crew and the entire Draconis Combine.
Hey, I got orders, Doc. All non-essential personnel are confined to quarters.
I fail to see why all Kuritas should be punished for the actions of one individual.
Figure it out on your own time. All right, which one of your buddies swiped the elemental suit?
Why? Is one missing?
Tell me who you're working with now!
Galen, what's going on out there? Galen!
He... just unconscious.
But I've got other plans for you, Victor.
Stevens?
But why?
Let's just say there are factions within the Federated Commonwealth who favor a more worthy successor to the throne.
Hold her right there, pal. Copy, Franklin.
Do you copy? Yes, Major. I believe I do.
Thank you. how did you know the assassin was Stevens?
When you found me aboard the Hegira, I was examining their computer log, searching for proof that they were targeting you before I fired upon them. I found an entry that a self-destruct program had been implemented in the Prince's mech. Clearly, someone aboard the Prince's ship was the assassin. Since I could not determine which was the culprit, I had to wait for him to make another move. When I learned of the missing elemental suit, I knew the assassin would strike again.
Why didn't you tell me any of this?
Would you have believed me?
Mr. Sakamoto, I am forever indebted to you for saving my life.
It was a matter of giri, of honor. Even if you are the son of my enemy. When you attain the throne, I hope you will not make me regret my actions.
You've got a brave crew, Major. We'll need their brand of valor on Trelwan and Somerset.
I'm afraid that's not gonna happen.
But what about our plans?
Victor Steiner Davion's courage in battle, and narrow escape from the clan forces, has spurred the men and women of the battalion to incredible acts of heroism. Morale remains high among the underground resistance on Trelwan, thanks in no small part to the continued survival of our prince. I'd hate to think where we'd be if you hadn't made it, Victor.
This clan invasion is bigger than either of us, cousin. And like it or not, we each have a greater responsibility to the entire Commonwealth than to any one planet or unit.
You know, you've gathered a great deal of intelligence on these clans, cousin. I suggest we put it to good use and plot a strategy for the clan's defeat.
Holds up to 40 Star Wars action figures, like New Squidhead and Emperor's Royal Guard, each sold separately. And besides the new C-3PO collector's case, there's a new Chewbacca bandolier strap, which over your shoulder for play and holds 10 action figures securely. Like new Princess Leia Organa and Rey's, each sold separately. It even has pouches.
New C-3PO collector's case, Chewbacca bandolier strap, and action figures, each sold separately from Kenner's Star Wars Return of the Jedi collection.
Now you can imagine all the power in the universe. The Masters of the Universe collection. 23 pieces, each sold separately. There's He-Man and these heroic action figures. Skeletor and the Warriors of Evil, and four fighting creatures. Castle Grayskull, Point Dread, and the Talon Fighter. You put them together. And battle machines like the Attack Track, batteries not included.
What would you do with all the power in the universe?
Wow. He-Man, Skeletor, and all other items from the Masters of the Universe collection, each sold separately. From Mattel.
GoBots. And you control their every move. Behold, I pour. Copter. Turbo. And Psy-Kill. The GoBot invasion has begun.
My GoBot, my invasion.
GoBot. GoBot.
I just now seen this for the first time ever. That's right. Mead, back in the day, made, boom, 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 boom. Look at those. Those are awesome. Look at that. Freaking early trapper keepers and stuff like that. Organizers. Now have comic book stuff on them. Notebooks. One comes with an iron-on transfer. That's awesome. You'd have your Captain America ream of paper. So. All right. Hope you guys still digging on the Battletech. I know I do. Like I said, the CGI isn't the best, but man, the long-term storytelling in this story, the fact that it goes one episode to the next episode, it's not just one-offs, it's great. stuff that I thought kids' cartoons missed when I was younger. Mind you, this was by the time Battletech came out, I was not a child. But I like the progressive storytelling that we got from Battletech. And stuff like Battletech, and stuff like the Flash, the cartoon that Filmation did, that they changed in the second season because people didn't like the serialized storytelling of it. But I do. So, we go from giant robots to extra large robots. That's right, we're going to some Megas XLR. Oh my god, man. Megas has one of the best guest voice actors, I think, of any series ever. Serious. Michael Dorn. Freaking Bruce Campbell. Come on. This is epic. Clancy Brown. God, they just killed it back in the day. And it doesn't hurt. It's a stupid good cartoon. It's enjoyable as hell. I love this cartoon. The fact that it's a giant robot with a car for a head makes it even funnier. But this is Megas XLR Episode 4, and this is The Fat and the Furious, because parodies of The Fast and the Furious have been around for a long time. Enjoy.
So, how did this happen again?
I love fake cheese!
Hey, what do you think would happen if we put some cheese in that duotronium isolinear actuator thing?
Come on, do it! Do it!
Huh? I told him not to do it. Hey!
Ugh, just stop that thing!
Oh, right!
Was that absolutely necessary?
Look cool to me. And go easy with the wax. Gotta look good for the car show. You see? No worries. Everything's back to normal.
Got a giant robot category?
No, man.
How about an ultra-modified category?
Ultra-modified it is.
Rock on! Man, I hope I win the trophy this year.
They actually give out a trophy for a car?
What do they give out in the future?
We don't have auto shows. We're too busy fighting to stay alive.
Too busy fighting to stay alive? How long are you gonna milk that thing for?
Hey guys, check out my sweet ride. The trophy is as good as mine. Yo!
What kind of engine you got in there?
Well, which one? I've got one for suborbital, one for transwarp, one for cruising the streets. I haven't figured out what the other six do, though.
Is it hard to steer?
Nah. Not if you've mastered a Z-pad and a joystick.
Can I get a picture?
Sure thing.
Not you. Her.
Actually, I'd prefer if you didn't.
Ooh. Competition looks tough this year.
Dude, you got a giant robot from the future with a car for a head.
Yeah, but check out that custom 42 pickup. And this striped 4x4 with the modular shell. And I don't even want to think about that 65 lowrider with the green shag trim and the chain link steering wheel.
Hola, Coop.
Aw, I should have known.
Takes more than a fancy paint job to win around here, you know.
That sounds like a challenge.
Let's do it.
What? Is he part of the show?
For 12 bucks, it ought to be. Poop! What are you doing?
It's not my fault! Something's wrong! I've lost control!
Poop, shut it down! Now!
I'm trying! It won't respond! Sorry about that! Wow!
Nice of you to help.
Looks like Coop is doing enough damage without me. What the heck's going on?
I have no idea, but we have to stop it before Coop hurts someone.
Hey, wanna check under my hood? Sour cream and onion. Who doesn't love that?
Coop, you gotta shut Magus down.
Nothing I try is working.
Get the CPU core offline somehow. That should power down all the systems.
Sorry about this, Magus.
Hey, Coop, did you see that chick? I think she digs me, man.
I'm really sorry.
You're awesome.
Make a go, Coop.
You're the man. Yeah.
Yo, that's the way to go, baby.
Man, where'd you learn to drive like that?
Hey, you know, just comes natural, I guess.
I'm still gonna take the Motorhead prize.
We'll see.
Well, at least the worst is over. happened to the computer core. Well, it should work now. I just needed to de-cheese it.
Hey, if I had a spork, I'd de-cheese it myself.
I think you've done enough.
Yeah, no kidding. You're like a trouble magnet. So, Red, want a ride in this year's soon-to-be-winning car?
My name is Kiva.
Winning car? Goat, your ride is a piece of...
I know that sound. Those are Mark 7 inversion thrusters.
Hey, Coop, friends of yours?
There it is. My key to universal domination. Sure, the CPU core is gone. Gone? Well, where the flarp is it? Scanning.
We got problems.
I have an idea. Whatever happens, they can't get that core.
Guess it's just us guys, huh?
Yeah. See ya!
Hey, hold on, man! You can't leave Coop hanging!
Is it... Ah! Wait up!
Sir, that Earther has the CPU core. Get me that core! The prototype is useless without it! Stop him! Weapons! You might destroy the CPU core!
Running for chumps!
Get in!
Disable that vehicle! Take out the road!
Want me to take over now?
If you can pilot Magus, I think I can handle an archaic automobile.
Wanted to do that.
You always wanted to do that?
Guy thing. There! Yo, Jamie! Catch! Go, go!
Oh, man!
Why'd I take a scooter?
Yo, I'm open! You oversized slugs got a problem with my boys? I got a problem with you!
Don't let these primordial imbeciles outsmart you! Get me that Delorpin core!
Now's our chance!
Stop them before they escape! Destroy that structure! And bring me that CPU core!
Sorry. Got carried away.
Find the Earther! And find the core!
Whoa. That Kiva is one hard-driving, high-flying, future-packing mama.
Oh, man. They're really outnumbered.
No sweat. We just need a little help.
That don't look too bad.
I might be able to fix it, but I need some time.
There they are. I must admit that your strategies are strange and cunning, but mostly strange. Now to finish this dance.
You want to dance? Okay, we'll dance. We're going manual.
Manual? Whatever made you install a manual backup?
It's complicated.
Coop, it looks like these modifications can only mimic your exact moves. And you have no access to the weapons array.
Don't need them. Got a better idea?
Keep them off us for as long as you can.
Earther! Prepare for your end!
Oh, no. I'm just getting started. How's it going, Kiva?
I need more time.
I don't know how much longer I can hold these guys off.
What's this?
Let's show these alien slime balls how we do things in Jersey.
Rock on!
Do you guys really need me for this?
All right!
Nice moves, Coop.
Wait up. You guys need me. You're in my seat. And why are you wasting time on that thing? Coop can do it manually.
Let's see. A computer that can process 7.2 million defensive and offensive maneuvers a second? Or that?
Less talk, more work. Fake left! Fake down! Watch the guy on your left! My left!
We have the same left!
Oh, yeah. Right.
Oh, I need a bridge to complete the circuit.
Hurry! What's taking so long?
Here, hold this. And this. CPU online.
Nice.
Watch the paint! Watch the paint!
Way to go, Coop!
All right, you intergalactic snots! You busted up my car show!
Yeah!
You wrecked my friend's rides!
Yeah!
And you made me run half a block!
Yeah! Half a block?
Now, it's payback time!
He's too strong! Keep fighting! Stand and fight! Who ordered a retreat?
Sir, we can't afford to lose any more men.
Don't think this is over, monkey boy.
I may be a monkey, but I ain't no chicken.
I'll play your game, Earther Scum.
Coop, no!
Are you nuts?
Hey, you came here.
Ha ha ha! Pathetic! No one can defeat me! Oh no. A temporary setback! You haven't seen the last of me, Arthur! I will return and annihilate your—
Yeah, you always say that.
You space freak! Yeah!
And the Grand Master of this year's auto show is, by a unanimous vote, Kiva!
What?
Who?
Oh, man.
Yeah. We all agree that the way you rebuilt the CPU after Coop smashed it was pure mechanical genius.
Yeah, well...
So it gives me great pleasure to present you with the Golden Steering Wheel Trophy.
When I first got into modifying vehicles, I never dreamed it would be for anything other than superior firepower or tactical domination.
Well, I guess she deserves it.
So, Coop... How's about we finish our little competition, huh?
Now you're talking. How'd this work again?
But now I've seen that cars... Coop, wait! I haven't finished fixing the car yet!
It's all right, it's cool. I stopped it. Hey, it's not so bad. We can still salvage the cars. Yeah. Okay then. Who's up for popcorn chicken?
It's the 6x6 high-riser power cruiser. You can play with it alone or with other high-risers like the Atlas, each sold separately. It's a complete action station with a pivoting boom and working searchlight. And six-wheel drive and independent suspension make it almost unstoppable.
It's rocking and it's rolling, almost no place it's not going.
Two AA batteries not included. The 6x6 high-riser power cruiser and Atlas, each sold separately. From Ideal.
Enough of this jungle.
It's Indiana Jones, a large-size action figure.
That boulder's coming in fast.
He's new from Kenner's Raiders of the Lost Ark collection.
Stay low, Indiana. They're right behind you. Use your whip.
Whoa, I'm slipping.
Oh!
A six-six.
Get me out of here.
Now. Indiana Jones, a large-size action figure from Raiders of the Lost Ark collection. New from Kenner.
Okay, so I gotta ask. It's Saturday afternoon, you got done watching cartoons, you busted out your Atari, it's 1982, what game are you playing? Boom, are you playing Burger Time, or are you playing Star Wars Arena? Which one are you playing? I owned both of them, but I am a Star Wars nut, and even though this game was not good, I still played the hell out of that game. I still own that game. It's still in my Atari game collection. It's all boxed up, put away, because I never play Atari anymore. But I still own that game. I own both of those. I own Empire Strikes Back and Jedi Arena. So, I hope you guys are still digging Megas XLR. Because I do. And I will run this cartoon till they can't run it no more. I run out of cartoons, or they tell me I can't. So, alright. We're going to go along, and we're going back to Fox Kids. Man, damn, I love some Fox Kids stuff. Not all of it was great. Some of it was really good. Some of it was okay. But this is the one that's just crazy. We're going back to Eek the Cat. Man, just Eek the Cat fun, crazy cartoon, and I don't know how to put it anyway. I know this is late, or maybe it's really, really early, because this is the Halloween episode of Eek the Cat. This is Hallow-Eek. Enjoy.
Eek! Help! Eek! Help!
Phew. Too scary for the little trick-or-treaters. It just wouldn't be Halloween without a good scare.
Trick-or-treat!
Happy Halloween!
Trick-or-treat!
Oh, isn't that sweet? A nice angel, and a funny clown, and oh, what's this? Are you a real dragon?
Kumbaya!
I think it's supposed to be like this.
Halloween is ruined.
We're crying on my head, Wendy Elizabeth.
I can't help it. We can't wear our costume. We won't get any candy.
I just can't bear to see their Halloween ruined. I must help them. But how? Ah, that's it.
There must be a way to do this. Maybe if we just try the head on.
Hey, Clannad! Mom!
Where are we going?
Why, eek, you little scamp! How did you get in there? That's it! Glorioski children, we're saved. I have a brilliant idea. Eek can steer.
Yay! Yay!
Well, I'm glad that's taken care of.
Kumbaya, that was close. Now if I can just zero in on some tasty treats, that'll make the kids' Halloween extra special.
That sounds like the old lady out on the street who's got more money than she knows what to do with. Come on!
Phew! I thought I'd lost you, kid. Come on, let's go find those elusive Halloween treats.
Hey, what are you doing?
You promised I could be the head this year. You promised.
Look, Lance, you're just better as the horse's butt. You've been the horse's butt for 6 years. You're good at it.
That does it. I have had it. I am not moving another step.
Fine, we'll just stand here in the middle of the street. Is that what you want?
Well, obviously, it doesn't matter what I want.
Fine, we'll just stand in the street.
Fine. Leon.
And the last thing Ichabod Crane saw was the headless horseman. His head now replaced by a shrieking jack-o'-lantern galloping towards him. Or so they say. You see, no one ever saw Ichabod Crane again.
Gosh, Mr. Eyewater, you sure are a scary man.
Can we go back inside now?
It's okay, kids. It's just an old ghost story. It didn't really happen.
Boss is taking a nap. He don't want to be disturbed.
Gee, these kids are a lot taller than I remember. Yikes! Ouch!
Go on, hit the piñata, Jorge. If you hit it hard enough, all the Halloween candy will fall out.
Being a chicken head is quite a skill. Well, I'll be. That's a clever costume. A kid dressed up like some kind of upside-down person with a club. Oh, gosh, it hurts! Ooh, Kumbaya! I've stumbled into some kind of a cemetery or something, and it's Halloween night. I hope I don't run into any ghosts. Of course, luckily for me, there's no such thing as ghosts. Therefore, there's nothing to be afraid of.
Boo-hoo!
Rah!
Boo-hoo!
What is it? What do you want? Are you a ghost?
Well, yeah. Aren't you?
Well, no, not yet. I'm a cat.
What are you doing in a cemetery if you're not a ghost?
Good question. My name is Zeke, and I think I'm a little lost. I was trick-or-treating with my family when we got separated. I gotta find him before something terrible happens.
That makes two of us. I'm Crypty, and I'm lost, too. I've lost my whole family. Boo-hoo, boo-hoo.
Nice to meet you, Crypty. Well, gee, Crypty, maybe I can help you find your family while I look for mine. We'll be a team. Partners.
You'd help me?
Why, sure. It never hurts to help. Come on, buck up. That's the spirit.
Where?
Never mind. It's just an expression. Come on, let's go find your ghost folks. I never met a real live, ghost before.
We only come back to Earth one night a year. I came on a tour bus with my family and a bunch of other ghosts. At the graveyard, we were playing hide-and-go-shriek. I was so well hidden in an urn that when I came out, everyone was gone. They must have continued on the rest of the tour and forgotten about me.
I doubt that, Crippy. They're probably very worried by now. But don't you worry. We have all the time in the world to find your family.
Oh, no, we don't. See, we ghosts are allowed to visit Earth only on Halloween night. And we gotta get back to Ghostland before the clock strikes 12, or we'll be stuck here wandering the Earth forever as lost souls.
I was not aware of that. Well, we won't let that happen to you, Crypty. We'll find your pals before midnight. Now, Sink, where might your friends go?
They could be anywhere. Hey, wait a minute! They said something about an old house they thought they'd try and haunt.
Old house, you say? I wonder which old house and where.
Yellow pages, man.
No, you fool. The Book of Spirit Entrapment. Tonight, when the clock strikes 12, all the ghosts of the world shall be mine.
Hello? Hello, is anybody home?
Hello, Uncle Finster, Cousin Fruit.
What's that noise?
Sounds like it's just some loose floorboards.
Can we be sure that it's just a loose floorboard?
Well, there's a clue.
I'm relieved, truly.
We better split up, Eek. You go that way and I'll go this way. Holler if you find any ghosts.
Oh, you can count on it, Crypty. Hello? Anybody's... anybody home?
One pair of ostrich lips.
Check.
One eye of Newt.
Check.
One used Bigfoot diaper.
Ew. Check.
One heart of a lawyer.
But we don't have a heart of a lawyer.
That's because there's no such thing. It was just a joke, man. A dash of hot sauce.
Check.
And finally, 20 toes of two bickering children.
What? You mean live bickering children?
That's what it says, and this time it's no joke, man.
Two bickering children? Two bickering children? Where are we gonna find two live bickering children?
Top of your head anymore? Or does that metal plate in your skull preclude all sense of feeling?
I don't have a metal plate in my skull.
Do so.
Do not.
Say.
Not.
Say.
I do not. This is the worst Halloween ever. We haven't even gotten any candy.
Mr. Ghosty? Hello? Hello, is anybody home? Where are you? Mr. Ghost? Hello? Anybody down there? Nobody down here. Something fishy's going on. Who turned out the lights? Huh? I gotta remember to use more moisturizer. My skin isn't... Hey! Hey! Get it off! Get it off!
Good morning. Will you be joining us? We'd love to have you for breakfast, wouldn't we, girls?
Uh-huh. Won't you be my neighbor? Let's get out of here. This place is boring.
Can I help you, fellas?
Oh, hi, Mr. Bat. We were just looking for some ghosts. Have you seen any here tonight?
Honey, dinner's ready.
All right, honey, just a minute! Yeah, there were a whole bunch here earlier, but they got bored and left. As you can see, there's not much going on here.
Did they say where they were going?
Come on, honey, you better eat your soup before it clots.
I'm coming already! Yeah, they said something about the old Tanamount Dance Hall on Oak Street.
Honey!
Yeah, I'm blind, I ain't deaf, you know.
I sure hope my ghost pals are at the dance hall.
Yeah, and maybe we'll find my kids along the way, too.
Hey, that's my squishy bar.
It's mine. You can have these green jelly beans.
Give me that squishy bar.
No.
Well, if it isn't the pair of bickering children.
Yes, man, complete with 20 wiggling stinky toes.
They'll be perfect. Enjoying your treats, children? Yeah, okay. How about now? Yeah, still good.
Give me strength, man.
Now, lower the 20 wiggling toes of bickering children, and our ghost nectar shall bring these partying spirits to their doom.
But the children are not bickering, man.
Oh, yeah? Watch this. Hey, give me!
It's mine, you jerk!
You're the jerk! Let's get busy!
You're my friend! This night hasn't been a total loss after all. Saki, do that, Saki. Why, if she was much smaller, this witch thing would be different, man, I'll tell you.
Do it, you mumbling feline. Throw the switches.
Kumbaya, your ghostly friends are under some kind of a sinister spell or something. I'm not a ghost, so this diabolical mist cannot affect me. Beep. I was wrong.
Ha 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 ha! Welcome, my pathetic poltergeist prisoners!
What do you want with us?
I want your ghost powder.
Or what?
Your ghost powder! You know, that dusty, chalky, white stuff you darn ghosts are all made up of? Soon you'll all be ground up for my main ingredient in my new cosmetic line! New spirit for the gal who likes to make a specter of herself.
You're mean.
Yes, but I'm cute, so I get away with it. Hit it, Zaggy!
I was never cut out for this manual labor, man.
What now?
We gotta break out of here.
With what? We're soft and transparent.
Hello, I'm Eek.
Hello, Eek. We're doomed.
Well, what do you mean?
That mean witch is about to do us all in. We'll never get out of here alive. I mean, we're ghost toasties.
Never give up hope, Mr. Ghost. No matter how gloomy a situation seems, there's always a solution. There's bound to be a way out of this aquarium.
But this aquarium's made from ghost-proof material.
Well, I'm not a ghost.
You're right.
Eek!
Can we use your head to break the wall of our confines?
Sure, it never hurts to help.
Now we'll see who's the powder puff, you bad witch!
You little pillowcases with eyes! You'll spoil everything!
Hey, we're out of candy!
This rub looks good! Don't come any closer! I'll scream! I'll do it! I will!
Really neat of you to go to all the trouble of setting up this phony haunted house, but we gotta go.
Yeah, we're going to have our stomachs pumped. They're having a 2-for-1 Halloween special down at Mick Trouble's Memorial. Bye, Eek.
Hey, lady, are you all right?
Oh, I swallowed the ghost catching potion. Ew, this can't be good. What's gonna happen to me?
Oh, this is no good for you, babe. No good at all.
What?
But it is good for me. It says here you turn into a small radish.
What?
Sorry, rodent. Now you can be my little helper.
Sure. Anything you say, Ziggy.
I think we go to Jamaica, man. You serve me many tropical drinks. Live the good life.
Whatever you say, Ziggy. Whatever you say sounds good to me.
Hey, thanks for saving us, Eek.
Yeah, if you hadn't come along, we wouldn't have stood a ghost of a chance.
You sure are a great pal, Eek.
It was sure fun meeting you, Crypty. It's too bad you guys gotta go.
Hey, you wanna come with us back to Ghostland?
But I'm not a ghost.
You could be.
No. Thanks anyway. You guys go on, and maybe I'll see you next Halloween.
All right, then.
Bye, Eek.
Bye, Crypty. Say hello to Elvis for me.
Elvis? I haven't seen Elvis.
Happy Halloween. Boy, Halloween sure is a great time for everybody. I think it's my favorite holiday of the year. I mean, except for Christmas. And Thanksgiving. And, well, Arbor Day. And I like Easter. Valentine's Day is nice. The 4th of July, May Day.
Captain O.G. Readmore here. I've got a great suggestion for fun that's out of sight. Get the family together for a family reading night. Turn Grandma into Captain Hook, let Dad play Gung again. Pick your favorite book, give out the parts, and let the fun begin. It's hilarious. And it's easy. And it's great for any weather. Read a book tonight, you'll see I'm right. Reading is so together.
We'll return after these best.
Dress Pop, hooray! 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 Dress Pop's here today! You get a great
dress pop! Dress Pop, hooray! 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 Return of the Jedi. The Scout Walkers attack. The walking, fighting Scout Walker prepares to attack. This great Star Wars model has walking action, push-button controls to stand and attack, swivel head, movable side cannons. The Scout Walker can fight his own battles, win his own wars. But will he? Only you can decide with Star Wars toys.
There you go. Look at this Saturday morning lineup in 1979. Boom. Look at that. Look at that. CBS had it going on. Some Mighty Mouse, Heckle and Jekyll, the Bugs Bunny Roadrunner show at 9 o'clock. At 10:30, the all-new Popeye Hour. At 11:30, Fat Albert. At 12 noon, Jason the Star Command. And at 12:30, they were running cartoons till freaking, they did Saturday mornings until 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Jeez. So, all right. So, I hope you guys still dig Eek the Cat. And it's a fun cartoon, but we're going to keep it going. And we're going to a show I have become a pretty good fan of. I'm digging this cartoon, rediscovering it. And we're going back to Monster Force. And, oh, man. Just, they take it seriously. I mean, it's dark and it's taken pretty seriously. But this is Monster Force Episode 5, Dark Deception. Enjoy.
Some say this is the birthplace of evil. They say the first vampire spread its leathery wings here and stole its first blood. The skies scream with thunder here, offering little hope to the innocent.
Reed, watch out!
What?
Don't worry, Doc. I got it.
Thanks, Trip.
Man! I love this arm gizmo you rigged up. Lance, you know those juggling lessons you took? Ask for your money back.
Sorry, Reed. Guess I got carried away, but these books are great. There's still so much about Dracula I want to know.
That's why we're here. The Brethren have been collecting data since Dracula's reign of terror began in that castle 500 years ago. There is no better place than Transylvania to learn about the Prince of the Undead. And with Dracula halfway across the world, this is the perfect time for us to be here.
I'm almost finished downloading the manuscript into the compad.
Good, Luke. The Brothers only gave us 24 hours. We'll need months to read over everything we've compiled.
What?
Emacs on.
I knew there was gonna be trouble. But when were you ever right before?
There's always a first time.
Help!
Ten against one. Let's see if I can even up the odds a little bit. Stasis field set.
This man needs attention. Those vampires seemed real hungry for this guy.
Well, they better have lost their appetite.
He's been badly cut. Hang in there, old-timer.
Reed, wait. Something's wrong here. I'm picking up psychic screams.
Look here, Shelley. You're picking up vampire poison. He's been attacked, and more than once. Come on, he needs our help. His breathing's getting stronger.
Who is he?
My bag.
You're weak. Take it easy.
No. Give me my bag now.
It's okay. You're safe here.
Good. Everything is still here. Those creatures took nothing. Do you find my equipment amusing, Dr. Crawley?
You know me?
I know you've bungled your way around the world thinking you can cure monsters with your precious science. Look at this. You want to contain the beasts, but one doesn't study monsters. One destroys them. These are ridiculous toys, Crawley. But perhaps that's why you've given them to children.
Hey, that proto-neutralizer saved your butt.
Easy, Lance.
I didn't need your help, boy. I have everything I require right here.
You're a vampire hunter?
The last of a forgotten breed.
Dead last if we hadn't saved you back there.
I've tracked Dracul for 50 years, boy. You really think his mindless slaves could stop me?
Hey!
Ha! I've been bitten so many times I'm immune to their blasted poisons.
Of course. You're Abraham Stoker. I heard about you when I started my work, but then you vanished from sight.
You've wasted enough of my time. I need to get ready. Tonight, I'm searching Castle Dracul.
We were planning a trip there ourselves. We'll be your backup.
You really believe you're man enough to walk my path? Ha! I'd love to see you try.
You don't know Dr. Crawley, or us.
I know your kind. Midnight, the castle cemetery, if you have courage enough.
We're going to need some backup. Shelley, can you reach Frank?
We're gonna need him. Just listen to that comm pad.
Something's closing in. 30 meters? 20? 15? The signals are getting stronger, Reed. 10 meters, still moving in. 5 meters.
Come on. Let me get my hands on you.
4! It's behind us!
Such children. Without your science, you are nothing.
Stoker!
Be silent, Crawley, if you still insist upon following me.
Good going, Hotshot.
Hey, I chased him off, didn't I?
My tolerance to their venom has given me a psychic connection with vampires.
Kind of like my psychic senses.
What are your senses telling you now?
To keep our necks covered.
I'm picking up readings all around us.
More toys? A real vampire hunter can smell the undead.
Why do you keep putting down our weapons? Our EMAX just heighten our normal abilities.
EMAX?
Yeah. Energized monster arm containment suit. I've got weapons like the proto-neutralizer.
These wings let me fly. The suit also strengthens my psychic power so I can fire psi bursts.
You ain't seen nothing yet. My storm strike can take on anything that moves.
I don't need a suit.
We use one kind of weapon. You use another. But our mission is the same. To get rid of vampires.
We found their nest.
Let's see what you're made of. Remove the lid and leave the rest to me.
EMAX on full power.
Defend yourselves.
Cover your eyes. I'm launching a solar grenade.
You bugs hate sunlight, don't you? Maybe you want a permanent tan, too.
Stand back. Activating stasis generator. Oh. Ah! Yeah! Stasis generator activated.
Good. Get him into containment units.
No. I told you before, don't examine monsters. Destroy them. You know what I think of your toys.
No!
You freed them.
And I'll destroy them my way.
Reed! Unless you want to roast some weenies, let's get out of here!
Now they have one less place to hide. Well, are you coming? Or have you lost your nerve?
I don't like him.
We're going to need some backup. Shelly, reach Frank.
Castle Dracul, birthplace of the greatest and most powerful vampire of all. Other monsters cringe in his presence.
You don't see me shaking in my boots.
Enough of this disrespect. Dracul could destroy you fools with a snap of his finger.
Dr. Stoker, please. Lance didn't mean anything.
Very well, Crawley. But these children must learn to respect their enemy, underestimate Dracul's power, and you will not survive another night.
My students and I are here for research. Why are you in Transylvania?
Dracul and I have battled each other for half a century. I intend to destroy his original coffin to show him he cannot escape. You wish to prove yourselves? These doors lead to many rooms. Search them and report to me immediately if you find any coffins. Crawley, you must come with me. I'll show you how a veteran vampire hunter operates.
What do we do?
What he said. Keep your comm pads on voice contact. I don't want anyone getting lost here.
Guys, you gotta see this place. It's like a theme park for the terminally cruel.
Ow! That hurts!
Uh-oh.
I'm getting out of here.
Okay, be careful.
Hey, careful's my middle name. Reed. Something's coming at me.
What is it?
There's too many.
Blast your weight. What the? Trip! Can you hear me?
We have to save ourselves. Look! Viper's breath. Hurry, man, hurry! It disintegrates anything it touches.
Dead end. But I can blast our way free.
Your science is useless here, Crawley.
It's closing in.
If I know Dracul, he'll have a secret passage out of this room just about here!
How did you know?
Long ago, Dracul captured me. He kept me prisoner here for 10 years. But there is nothing about this castle I do not know. Now come, time is running out.
Lance, Shelley, Luke, can any of you hear me? Call in!
It's too late for them, Crawley. You should never have brought those children here.
Reed! They're coming after me! Get off me!
Shelley? Shelley!
You doomed her by bringing her here, Crawley.
Stop! I have to find them! Lance! Luke, can you hear me? Monster Force, report in!
Too many! Gah! Can't fight back!
Luke? Luke!
Reed! They're after me! They...
Lance, use your weapons! Fight back!
They're gone, Crawley. Your science couldn't protect them.
It's my fault.
Face it, Crawley, your monster hunters are gone.
No. Dracula wouldn't destroy them. He'd make them vampires. I can still save them. Which means I'll find them.
You suffer a fool's dream. Wake up!
You laugh at science, Doctor. But I'll show you it works. The density shift is unmistakable. There's a room behind this wall. And as you pointed out in the banquet hall, every room has a door. All you need is the key. We must be getting close to Dracula's chamber. You said Dracula had captured you?
And every day he threatened to turn me into one of his minions.
That must have been torture.
The strong survive, the weak perish.
I don't recognize the language.
It is ancient Romanian. Legend decrees that only the undead may pass through this portal.
Rules are made to be broken.
Dracul's private chamber.
Where's the welcoming committee? It's not like Dracula to leave his chambers unguarded.
We must work quickly. Pry open a coffin lid.
What? Luke?
Insane pursuit of Dracul has led these children to their destruction.
No!
They are not very happy with you. In fact, Reed, they want you to have this last coffin just for yourself.
You're not Stoker.
That fool. I destroyed him years ago.
As I will do unto you.
Dracula!
I wanted you to suffer. I wanted you to see your force destroyed before I finished you.
useless toys. I told you the old ways are better. To new ideas. Your Monster Force children. I believe I will turn them into my vampire slaves and let them destroy you in my name.
No!
Renfield?
Your humble servant.
Who shall I honor first?
Master.
Of course, the girl.
No!
What?
Jelly!
The Frankenstein monster!
Frank, stop Dracula!
Fool! My minions will destroy you as I destroy your friends! Impressive, but not good enough. I'll deal with you myself. You can't win, monster. I am your superior. I'll destroy you myself.
He's here!
Shelly!
Frank!
Oh, feels like a rap group exploded in my head. What happened? Yeah! Later. Hurry!
Did we win? You said Dracula was destroyed.
I wouldn't celebrate yet. With Dracula, things aren't always what they seem.
Let's go,
Ghostbuster toys, so much fun, it's spooky. Play Ghostbusters.
Let's go!
With your own play figures.
Come on there, Ghostbusters!
Jake has a magic backpack and ghost gun. Primeval has a real cape.
Look out, humans!
Ah! Pull yourself together, you rusty wreck!
That's spooky!
Ghostbuster figures from Shopper. So much fun, it's spooky.
Now you can be a member of a fighter pilot squadron with flying fighters.
Listen to them fly!
Six incredibly detailed fighters with super electronic sound. Flying Fighters comes with patch and poster.
McGruff here with Regina to say, users are losers.
You know it's okay to say no. I'm telling you it's true. Learning when to say no.
Hey, no.
That's
Alright, I hope you guys are still digging Monster Force. Yet again, this is a short series, got one season. We burned through this relatively quickly. I mean, it's not very long that Monster Force lasted, so. But it's still a good, enjoyable show. So, alright. We're going to keep it, I guess, in the monster genre. The supernatural, paranormal. And I brought it to you last week, and we're bringing it to you again. And that is the Roswell Conspiracies. This was, like I said, an animated series I did not discover right away. Ended up with some of the DVDs. I believe they were from the dollar store, if that tells you anything. But I do have several sets of the Roswell Conspiracies. But they tried. They really did. And I almost think this show was a little late. I think if it would have been like 5 years earlier, I think it would have really caught on. Because that would have been about the same time as Men in Black. That would have been about the same time as, you know, the Batman anime series. Same art style, same stuff like that. Man, I thought this would have been great in that era. But this is Roswell, episode Dose. And this is The Bait, part Dose. So, enjoy.
It's Kenner's new Betty Crocker Quick and Thick Shake Machine. 4D batteries not included.
Pour in your milk, add the mix, turn it on, it's fun to fix.
Quick and Thick, Shake Machine.
Fast or slow, round and round, tastes so good when she drinks it down.
Quick and Thick, Shake Machine.
Mmm, it's thick.
Betty Crocker Quick and Thick Shake Machine. With six mixes, new from Kenner.
Knight Rider. The Knight Rider Power Cycle with Kit on the pretend instrument panel.
Here he comes.
You can pretend Kit is talking, leading you to the enemy.
Say they're behind the fence. Let's get him, Kit.
He's gonna pass us.
Yeah.
The spin out lever.
Knight Rider.
Got us cool.
One more, Kit. Go to turbo.
Knight Rider.
You got me. You're no match for Knight Rider. Right, Kit?
The Knight Rider Power Cycle comes complete with spin out lever. Your parents have to put it together. New from Coleco.
This is funny. Sitting there going through this, reading this, and it's the Halloween costumes. Boom. I remember being a little kid, and I wanted that Hulk and Spider-Man costume so bad when I was a little kid. Never got either one. I have a full Spider-Man costume now. And, yeah, it's awesome. Yeah, Captain wears it, takes it and goes, hangs out, took the Vincent trick-or-treating with it. But I kind of wish I'd still love to have one, just to have the box and like have it up here in the background somewhere. So, and, hey, I hope you guys are digging Roswell, Conspiracies, not Roswell, because that's a completely different show. Because, that was about aliens, and a teen drama. So, this is not. So, we are going back to one of my favorite animes that I'm allowed to air, which is surprising because I love this anime. And we're going back to The Giver. That's right, The Giver. I put this at the end because it is a little more mature than the rest of the stuff, but you guys seem to dig it. No one seems to care. I love The Giver. Man, just cool stuff. I think I still have one Guyver toy floating around somewhere, packed away. But it's cool. So this is the Guyver, and this is episode 7. Enjoy.
At the dawn of creation, the gods arrived on Earth. Now we shall know their awful legacy and how it affects mankind. To rescue Tetsuro and Mizuki Sagawa, who had been kidnapped by Cronus, Sho Fukamachi went to Mount Narasawa and fought the most powerful Zoanoid, Enzyme. Enzyme's ferocious attack caused the Guyver to lose its control metal and meet his death in front of a horrified Tetsuro and Mizuki. Agito Makishima revealed that his true intentions were to defeat Cronus, then transformed into Guyver 3. Meanwhile, from the DNA still left intact in the control metal, Guyver 1 was reborn. Together, Guyvers 1 and 3 defeated the Hyperzoanoid Team 5 and the Ultra Hyperzoanoid created when Elegon and Zector merged into their ultimate state. The two Guyvers then demolished Cronus Japan, and Commander Gyuo fell into the flaming ruins of the building. But this was only the beginning of the battle between the Guyvers and Cronus.
This is Unit B. We have begun the operation to kidnap the Sagawa children. What's the matter? Respond, Unit A!
Respond! No response. We cannot wait for an answer from the other team. We must go ahead with our plan.
Affirmative, but our success in carrying out this particular operation is of the utmost importance.
It's time.
What the?
Who the hell is that?
Your kidnap's been canceled. I won't let you hurt them.
This operation. How the hell did he find out about it? Always find out our plans. I must report this to my superiors. Huh? Guyver 3?
Makishima! That
Thanks again for the tip. Tetsuro and Mizuki were saved. This time. But will they ever really be safe from danger? Is this going to go on forever?
We will have to continue fighting them. The building we destroyed was only one branch of Kronos. There are many more. They must be crushed completely. Be patient until I find their leaders.
Agito! Thank you!
So these are the ones who activated the units. If I follow them, I'm sure I can.
Destroyed was only one branch of Kronos. There are many more.
Makishima! Gyver 3. What are your true intentions?
I want to destroy them.
Shell, are you in there? Shell,
Dad?
I'm coming in, okay?
Father!
Why is your room as dark as a mineshaft? Here.
Welcome home, Dad.
My God.
I thought I'd take a little time out for a nap.
It's good to study, but don't overdo it, son. You look terrible.
Really, I'm fine.
We only have each other, son. We gotta take care of ourselves. Hey, after your exams are done, why don't you come out to the lake and go fishing with me?
Count me in. Father, I'm sorry, but there's no time to study. I don't know when Kronos will attack Tetsuro and Mizuki.
I'm sorry to have kept you waiting, sir.
Agito.
That voice again.
It has been a long time since I saw you last.
Dr. Balkas. He is like Gyuho, one of the elites, and the best scientist in Kronos. Why is he...
I am most disappointed in the failure of Kronos Japan.
Yes, I am also most grieved.
As is appropriate, but from now on, I will take command of this. Do you know this man?
Yes. Fumio Fukumachi, father of Sho Fukumachi, Gaiba 1.
Perhaps we should consider making use of this human. What are your thoughts, Agito?
We should consider kidnapping him immediately, as that is more valuable to us than kidnapping either of the Sagawa children could ever be.
I will entrust the details to you.
As you wish.
I will pay close attention to your progress, Makishima.
This isn't good, but I can't afford to lose my advantage. I have to be prepared to make sacrifices. Ultimately, Sho and Kronos are just steps. Steps in my future plans.
Show's late like always.
I wonder what could be keeping him.
Fukumachi, come back!
Show!
Sir, what was the matter with him?
Well, it seems there's been some kind of massive explosion at Fukumachi's father's company, I'm afraid.
Huh? How could it happen?
And what happened to Mr. Fukumachi?
No one could have survived it.
Can't be. You have to be mistaken.
was no one left alive.
Continue the search.
They didn't find your father.
Makishima, why didn't you tell me that my father was being sought after? I didn't know.
I also wasn't informed. Unfortunately, it was a confidential assignment.
But why my father?
Sho? Sho, listen. Don't be so hard on yourself. Nothing even to bury. Damn, Kronos. I'm sure I'm to blame.
What?
My father knew absolutely nothing about Kronos, and I thought he was safe, but I was wrong. And for that, I'm taking the blame. If I paid more attention, maybe I could have avoided this.
That's not right.
You know what I am. How my life has changed after I became the Guyver that day. How I only cause everyone around me pain and misery.
Don't say that. How could you know?
You see, it's very simple. They won't stop until they take everything and everyone I love from me.
Not us.
It'll be better for you if you stop trying to help me. Anyone who tries to help me will end up dead, with nothing left to bury. Kronos could just erase your memories easily, but they know how I care about my friends. They want me to suffer. That's why they killed my father, because of what I am.
There was nothing more that I could say.
Dad Zoro?
He's taking responsibility for everything, even for Takasato's office. Even what I'm to blame for. Kronos.
These are the old Zoonoids adapted by Kronos Japan. The rest are just sample bodies. Would you like to see those also?
The sample bodies, you say. I would like to review them.
These are the experimental models. There were numerous failures.
It's amazing they failed with so many bodies. Let me see that last one again.
Dr. Bacchus, there's a message for you. Please give your report.
As you have ordered, we have the Sagawa children, Dr. Bacchus.
Most efficient.
We will return immediately.
Agito, now we have them all where we can make use of them, don't we?
Yes. This is a most cunning man.
Oh, I have plans to use these hostages in what may prove to be an interesting manner.
Sho Fukumachi.
We have the Sagawa children. If you ever want to see them alive again, come to Riverside Park. Even if you try, you'll never escape from us.
I must fight. My only option is to fight them. I'll protect Tetsuro and Mizuki, even if it means my death.
So good of you to come.
I'm here.
So leave!
Shut up! Mizuki!
Stay there!
What have you done with Tetsuro?
He's sleeping in the back of the van, still alive for the time being.
If you do what we tell you, maybe you'll help keep them alive a little while longer.
I don't care what you do to me, as long as you leave Mizuki and Tetsuro alone.
Good. Then try these on. Okay, now turn around.
Mizuki!
That's too bad. Now you can't change into the Gaiva kid.
Shit.
That's right. You can't transform. If you did, you would form a barrier surrounding you and blast everything near you into oblivion. So the girl is our insurance that you don't change.
Of course you can transform if you don't mind killing the bitch.
Now come along with us and make it fast.
Don't.
Don't hit her!
Hold it, Bryce. Before that, I wanna play a little.
Rikuchi, stop!
I won't kill them just yet.
Who is that?
Are you okay, Fukamachi?
Yeah, I am, but how do you know my name?
Don't interfere. You killed Ramo Cheese.
I'd say that's a pretty safe assumption. Don't move.
Who are you?
Tell you later. Here, let me get you out of that. Stop moving!
Stay still, Mizuki!
Sister!
In this case, I don't believe your sister's human.
There's so many of them!
father, you damn solenoids! Amazing!
I have to try to find that man who helped us!
You can't get away!
Don't move! That's much better. Now I have some questions. Huh?
Get away from it!
He stopped me from finishing.
Are you all right?
I'm okay. You saved my life.
No! Thank you for saving me. But where's the real Mizuki?
They have failed again.
Doctor, we can make the adjustments you requested.
Fine. Now we can use that against him.
Mizuki? It's you.
Mr. Fukumachi!
Mizuki, why have you been brought to this place?
You're alive. Sho will be so happy. Oh, thank God! We all thought you were dead!
Freelance writer, Masaki Murakami. Why would a freelance writer involve himself like this?
I found out about Kronos after an accident happened. I've been after him ever since. It's become a personal thing.
I'm amazed you've even survived.
How about it, Sho Fukumachi? Will you join my battle and free your father?
Huh? What the hell are you saying? Are you telling me that my father is somewhere? Maybe still alive?
Yep. And your friend Tetsuro's little sister may be alive as well.
Where are they keeping my sister and Mr. Fukumachi?
Most likely at Mount Minakami, in the ruined base.
On Mount Minakami.
Inside!
Bang, bang, bang! Oh, howdy, partner. Time for timer.
Do you ever get that hungry feeling after school?
Boy, I do. I'm so hungry, I could eat a wagon wheel.
When I'm slow on the draw and I need something to chaw, I hanker for a hunk of cheese. When my 10-gallon hats are feeling 5 gallons flat, I got something planned, which is little cheese sandwiches. Come on!
Here's a great little snack to tide you over till dinner. If you want something delicious and nutritious, cheese is a super snack. Look, a wagon wheel.
When my get up and go has got up and went, I hanker for a hunk of cheese. When I'm dancing a hoe down and my boots kind of slow down, or anytime I'm weak in the knees, I hanker for a hunk of, a slab or slice a chunk of, a snacker day is a winner, and yet won't spoil my dinner. I hanker for a hunk of cheese. Yahoo!
Star Wars Return of the Jedi is here. From it, Kenner brings you 65 incredible Star Wars action figures, each sold separately. And now, Kenner reveals yet another from the dark side of the Force, the Supreme Master, the Emperor, and he's yours free just by sending 5 proofs of purchase from any Star Wars action figures to Return of the Jedi, Box 596, Young America, Minnesota. But hurry, this offer will end.
All right. We're drawing to an end today, but I'm going to put a bonus cartoon past the credits. So hopefully this gets past the YouTubes. I believe it will, but we always test it and throw it out there. So hang on, watch the credits. Hopefully there's a cartoon after that. So check it out. But we are going to talk some vinyl. And today we are talking about Rise of the Synths. Boom. The motion picture soundtrack by Ogre that does not really have a movie. It's made like it is a movie. It has the soundtrack. Even has the, like, narrated by John Carpenter, all that stuff like that. But yeah, not a movie. Boom. It's really good. This is a great synth. Look at that. Boom. Colored green and yellow vinyl. Pressed on colored yellow and green marble. So yeah. But this kicks butt. If you like synthwave music and you like it in movies, this is cool. Except for there's no movie for it to go to. So. Alright. So. The Cabin does a lot of work here. Next week is our big 2-year anniversary episode that I'm currently working on. So there will be no Saturday morning, or Saturday morning, there will be a Saturday morning serials next week. And I'm putting it together to do something really cool. No Sci Fridays next week. That gives me more time. Instead of working on 2 episodes, I can knock out the 1 big episode. So I apologize for those who watch Sci Fridays and get excited about it. You guys are awesome. Thank you. And we got the return of Piqua Comic Con at the now Piqua Center Mall, formerly Miami Valley Center Mall. Man, tables are selling quickly. We're getting booked up. We got a lot of cool guests. We got a lot of cool stuff going on. So follow us at Piqua Comic Con on Facebook, or you can find me, the Captain, Paulie, on Facebook, and Are You Game, and you can all connect through that. And I love the fact you guys are reaching out to me and emailing me, and I'm having a blast. I appreciate it so much. You guys are so awesome. You know, I always put it out there that you know, I have some of the best fans. I'm not gonna lie. You guys are great. You're here every Saturday morning. You're watching cartoons with us, watching, you know, together. I mean, that's why I do it. It's a shared experience, and thank you. It's so much fun. It's so cool. So yeah. But as I'm scrolling my phone here, boom. All right. So I want to, you know, put this out there. I'm currently working on stuff, getting some sponsorship, getting some t-shirts made, all that stuff. Again, I know I've been promising those forever, but man, I just haven't found any I like yet, and that's a problem. I don't want to do half-assed. I want some really cool, because if it's going to have my face on it, I don't want it to be dumb. Just, I'm not going to lie. So, taking that time. Working on some cool sponsors. Hopefully, I'm just negotiating with some cool sponsors now. Hopefully, we can get those guys attached. Maybe I can start handing out free stuff again. That's my goal. And I'm working on something. I know it's way off, but I think I'm going to give away something really pretty cool when we hit like 10,000 subscribers. I mean, we're only at like 7,300 right now. And that's 2,700 off. But last year at this time, man, we started getting a bunch of subscribers. So, man, tell your friends, subscribe, hit the like button, all that fun stuff. You guys just help me out. We're doing some cool stuff. So, as I keep saying cool stuff, because I don't know why. So, we're going to do some shout-outs. Yet again, shout-out to Johnny Wayne. Ah, you're awesome, dude. Maria, you're awesome. Boom. We talked about Secret Wars figures. Those are expensive, and those are the only ones I really need. And I just kind of get, if I luck into them, I luck into them. If I don't, it's not. Eh. So, here we go. Robert, Lone Swordsman, Warren, Paula, Valley, the guys at Way Out Toys Comics. You guys are awesome. Stay cool, man. You know, Chad and the Bunny, Maddie Bot, Jay. Jeez, I'm sitting here looking at this. James. Wow. You guys are all awesome. Brian, James, James C. You guys are several Jameses. You guys are awesome. Brian. I'm talking to some of you guys that did not get the chance to talk online, but will hang out and come back and talk to me later in the comments. Kevin, geez, Gabriella, you guys are fun. You guys are awesome. Thank you for watching. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for hanging in there with me. It's been a hell of a ride for 2 years, closing on 2 years. And I hope you really like next week's episode. So, for me and for Skeletor, boom, He-Man can bite it. So take care. I will see you all there, and Captain out.
Swap meet. I'll be back late. Dinner's yesterday's buffalo stew. See you then.
Listen to me, Frank. A third volcanic island has lifted its fiery head from the Pacific. Scientists are unsure what it means, other than there'll be a hot time in the old town tonight.
Bless this homework, O wise one. Hey, you miss me, Thor? Yeah!
Whoa, package delivery! Probably something of Mom's. Just leave it, please! Wow, this ain't for Mom. It's for me? Huh, wonder who could have sent it. Cool, looks Egyptian. Ah, that's it. Okay, that's an Inwich, and that's a Nit, which means strong or mighty. You have been chosen to be the cap bearer? Go to the mini mart and wait for a sign Mighty Max. Mighty Max? I'm dreaming.
I'm so close to release.
Go!
Find him first and bring me his beating heart. And I'll beat it raw.
Whoa! What a rush! Man, I don't think they made this one in Taiwan. I guess I blew a fuse or something. So, you think I'm dumb enough to go to that mini mart? Boy, I hope this is some kind of joke. Well, at least I'll pick up an El Supremo comic if nothing else.
What in the... Not the cupcakes!
Big Ed?
Back. Taste my Louisville Slugger, sucker! Get out of here, Max!
Max! Hasta la bye-bye, whatever you is! I don't believe it! Second floor! Wow!
At last, the Mighty One. Ah, I see you received my package as prophesied 5,000 years ago. Do help him up, Norman. After all, you are the guardian of the Mighty One.
Hey! Yeah! Don't mess with me, buddy. I know the ancient deadly art of, voodoo. Yeah, and I can rip your eyes out and show them to you before you die.
Right then, just follow us to the portal, Mighty Max. It must be around here somewhere.
Ah, glad that's settled. I'd hate to hurt either of you two guys. So, where are we?
Mongolia.
Mongolia? Hey, what are you talking about, man? How'd I get here?
Oh, here it is.
Hey, wait for me! Okay, now what's this all about? And how can you look like a chicken?
My name is Virgil, and I'm a fowl, not a chicken. You are Mighty Max, the Chosen One.
Chosen One? Oh, what'd I win? Cash? Prizes? Video games? Where's that McMahon?
All will be explained, but we must hurry. Just step forward into the portal.
Look! I just see rock, and if you think... What's happening? What's happening? All right. If you don't come clean with what just happened, man, I am gone!
Well, if you insist... But I've only had 5 eons to practice this speech. Here goes. Every person has a gift, and in their gift lies their destiny. You, Mighty Max, are a hero, and you have been chosen to wear the last cosmic cap to victory. As such, you, the wearer of the cap, have access to the long-lost transport of the gods.
Hey! Hey, it's glowing!
Sort of a super subway system, as it were. Come along. You are the focus of the powers of good. Norman and I are here to aid and serve you.
Oh, don't feel so bad, big guy. There'll be other heads to chop, I'm sure.
I am very wise and shall instruct you in the ways of being a hero. My speciality.
Great. Chicken teaching me to be brave.
Norman is your guardian, the ultimate bodyguard, as it were. He's quite unstoppable. He shall protect you from the smaller inconveniences that crop up from time to time. Where is that portal? You're it, Mighty Max.
Yeah, but this mighty stuff, it sounds wussy.
Mighty is a title of courtesy, like Mr. or King.
Hey, this is my block! I'm back home!
You are mighty, understand?
Yeah, if you say so, just don't call me that, okay?
Yes, Mighty Max.
And another thing, what was the flaming pyro thingy waiting for me at the mini-mart?
A lava beast. And at the ordained mini-mart. Skullmaster knows of you. Then he must almost be free if he has sent his minions.
Is there something you're not telling me? Look, I think I should know whether this house has a basement or not, okay? I mean, I've only lived here all my life.
No, it says so in the scroll. I'm sure there's a basement around here. Looking for this?
I guess there is one. Whoa! You mean this was down here all the time? Cool!
Stop! Look at your cap! This is the gateway to Skull Mountain.
In my basement?
What better place? You are the chosen one.
Oh, great, Verge. So, Skullmaster's on the other side of that? And he's probably got a million zillion lava beasts with him, huh? Come on, a guy'd have to be a complete moron to go through there, then. I'm not going, no matter what. Wow! Virgil! He's gone. Wow. I guess a chosen one's gotta do what a chosen one's gotta do. Well, here's to saving the world. And Mom, and my friends, and Virgil. No chance we had the wrong address, huh? Norman! Big guy! Oh!
Blast! one. Turn around so I may see you.
No, no, don't tell me. Let me guess. Skullmaster, right?
You're the chosen one, prophesied to destroy me. You're a worm. An insect. I'm nothing.
Hey, don't get me steamed, bonehead, or I'll gnaw your ankles off. Gee, I sounded tough enough.
5,000 years of anger and fear, and now I find you are naught at all.
Great! Then we can be friends? Shake? Whoa, 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 one second thought. Wait! I think I hear my mom calling me. You know, I'd really love to stay and chat, but she's a real monster if I'm not home by dinner, so...
More than me. Time to die, chosen one. The crystal!
Well, well, well. One more step, big fella, and this puppy takes a fall. Comprende?
Don't touch that crystal!
You were saying?
No! Do you think you can run away from me?
Virgil!
Chosen one, I knew you'd come.
Yeah, well, can't let you go hogging the glory and all.
Ah, wonderful. Now on to Skullmaster.
Yeah, look, Virgil, before we do anything rash...
the Chosen One.
Uh-oh, I think we're in deep dish pizza now.
Kill.
Kill! Kill! Hey, Virgil, can chickens fly?
What was that? This is gonna be fun. That was fun.
Oh man, that was great!
Would someone mind terribly? Thank you.
Mighty Max says, find us the portal out of here fast or kiss your kebabs goodbye. Like someone's rototiller got a little out of hand, huh?
The portal should be just up ahead, maybe another 30 feet.
Virg! The portal's 30 feet out there in midair? Over that? Oh, man, someone tell me there's another way out.
There isn't.
Skullmaster!
Have no fear, you are destined to win.
Good to see you again, Mr. Skullmaster. Scully, so, how are you doing?
Can't escape. I'll rip your limbs from your body and slowly suck the marrow from your bones.
That's it. We're has-beens. But I'm taking that sucker with me.
Oh,
open wide and say, ah! Woo! Yes! Ha! Don't mess with Mighty Max, you ugly bozo!
What are you doing?
Being the Mighty One! I hope you're right about that portal being out there, Virgil.
The math has never been wrong in 5,000 years, and... What? No. You don't mean...
What, like we have a chance here? Am I Mighty Max or aren't I? One?
Will die, Chosen One. You will die!
Go for it!
Alive and so bold on Earth?
But where on Earth?
Somewhere in Australia, I think. Should be a portal to Madagascar, only 50 miles or so from here.
50 miles? No way, Jose! Hey, I'm the Mighty One, you remember? I just saved the world from certain destruction. I ain't moving. Find a closer portal.
There aren't any.
Tough. I'm not going. Virgil? Norman? Hey, you guys, I was just kidding around. Can't you take a joke? So normal, buddy, a big hunk of nothing. How about a piggyback ride, huh? After all, I am Mighty Max. Oh, please.
Well, this week, we went to Mongolia and Egypt and then to India, where we saw the Taj Mahal. In 1630, Shah Jahan started building it as a shrine for his wife. It took 20,000 men 22 years to complete. You know, I think it'd take just about that long to clean my room. See you next week.